Dear students, welcome to the third lecture of the series on email etiquette. Today we are going to be discussing managing your mailbox. Sometimes a little beep or voice that comes from the computer or your laptop may be reminding you of constant interruption. To check your mailbox, the result could be that you would be finding yourself draining effect on your time. So what we should do is today we will be discussing that how you could regain your power and get some balance back into your working life in order to resolve and put email to its place as a tool which is going to help you and not to control you. We shall discuss the tips and techniques to help you to organize your mail, your mailbox and your time. Let's firstly look at the flowchart that shows you how do you respond to you have got an email. You're busy with an important task, so you choose to keep it aside and you carry on with your work and eventually respond to the email later. The second option is that you can take a moment and open and read that email directly. In both the cases, the first thing that you could face is that maybe the message, once you open it and read it, you find that the message is not for you. The message then in that case will be forwarded to the appropriate person and you will be letting the sender know about it. The other two ways in which you will be responding will include that you will simply choose to respond to the mail immediately. The other option is that you could be taking out some time to think and type out a detailed response which is required. In that case, you will send an email for acknowledging that you will be replying as soon as possible and you keep that email into to-do folder. Eventually, you can send the detailed response as soon as you will be able to. In that case, in fact, both the cases, what you could do is you could save the email draft or delete them or move your email to a folder which is very differently segregated. If required, you could also take the printout of the same email. Now, let's look at some of the steps to receive an email. The words of you have got an email resounding from your laptop can be received with a smile or a snarl, which will depend on what kind of day are you having. Some people have their message alert all the time, but this will only lead to interruption by a little beep or a voice. When you are working on an important project, please consider switching this off so that you can work uninterrupted. The next point is processing a mail. When you are going through your messages, scan each message very carefully and read the subject line and first paragraph. If necessary, you could also scan a little further into the message and make a decision whether you would like to do any of the four things mentioned. First, save or print it for reading later. Second, delete it. Third, forward it to someone else. Fourth, act on it. If you have to leave a message in your inbox with no evaluation at all, it simply means that you are simply going to read it again and again. This is just like you move a piece of paper around your desk from one tray to another and is equivalent to wasting a lot of time. So while you have to make a conscious choice of saving your mail for later, you could do that on the basis of assessing that either the mail is of lower priority or messages that don't need immediate attention, or it is there for reading only. Make sure that the filing of these messages is somewhere where you can find them later. You should not leave them in your inbox. The next point is where you could choose to delete the mail. We all understand that there are a lot of irrelevant messages that you receive, also known as junk email or spam. Since you usually throw paper junk mail straight into the waste paper bin, that's what exactly you are supposed to be doing to junk email too. Don't waste any time thinking or worrying about it, just delete that message. The next point is forward it to someone else. If you are not the right person to handle a particular message, then pass it on to someone who is. Just remember that it's good manner to include a note about why you are sending a particular message before forwarding this message, and while you are going to forward this message, you add a few lines, perhaps stating that, I think this is your department, can I pass it over to you? So that you let the sender also know where you have forwarded the message. And address of the person where the person could be contacted in future. The last option that you have is you could act on it. Many of the messages require a very simple and straightforward response. If you reply immediately, it's done with and you can forget about it. But if you need to give the matter some thought, do some research first and then put the message in your draft folder or highlight the message with priority setting, whatever feature that is available in your mailer. It is always courteous to send a quick reply first to acknowledge the message and inform the writer that you will get back to them soon. You could also add this to your written action list as well. The next option is auto-reply messages. If you are going to be away from the office for a particular time, especially when you are on a vacation or public holiday, make sure you are activating your auto-reply message. And while you do that, it will ensure that message will be received an automatic reply and people will not be kept in the dark, wondering why you have not replied. So your auto reply option could be used wisely. The next option is using the folder. Given the quantity of emails that arrive in your inbox, you will find it very useful to create a system of folders in which you can file and save the message you want to keep. You may find it useful to replicate the system of folders as you use on your computer as well or on your laptop. You could regularly transfer these messages to the respective folders at least once or twice a week. The next option is using filters. It's very easy for your inbox to become inundated with incoming mails, especially if you subscribe to automated mailing list. When you have so much in your inbox, it becomes very easy for you to miss the really important messages. The filters will actually help you deal with this problem. There are sets of rules in your mailer program that will help you set up that your mail is sorted into different piles, usually according to sender and the subject matter. So in this case, messages are filed automatically into different folders. Some filters will highlight key messages on the incoming mail list with priority codes or the colors that you choose. You can easily create a simple filing system by organizing your incoming mail into folders, wherein this would actually save a lot of time that you invest into searching for mails. You could have options or folders that include work, personal, articles, to-do, such examples. Now, as we move further, we can also look and understand that our filtering system can be set up to place messages from a mailing list into an appropriate folder so that clutter is removed from your inbox. You could delete unwanted messages. You could reply to messages with a courteous standard response so that correspondents know the action is underway. You could also detect messages that need special priority so that they sit at the top of your list. Now let's look at certain benefits of being organized. When you refer to a successful paper management system as a key element in organizational and time management skill, the other good thing that you could refer to would be successful management of email. While doing that, certain questions that you should ask to yourself about the current filing system include: is your inbox full of messages that are read but not filed? Do you have difficulty deciding where to file certain messages? Do you have difficulty finding messages again after you have filed them? Do you have difficulty identifying messages where action is outstanding? Are some of the folders bulging with mixed messages that should really be broken into subfolders? Are your folders and subfolders clearly labeled or easy to access? Is the filing system practical and easy to use? Once you have considered all these factors, you will be able to create a mail management system that is much more user-friendly. And now let's look at some of the star tips for effective email management. The points could include organizing your email into folders with email, just as you do with paper files. Considering turning off your message alert so that you can really focus on an important project. Clearing a clutter regularly, which applies on also using the word delete. Set up the filing system that is practical for you. Using the folders and subfolders will help you here. Set up the filter system so that incoming mail is automatically placed in the appropriate folders. Make sure that this will help you ease for your reference in future. Check your sent message folders also regularly and delete old messages that you do not need to keep. Change your auto reply every time you use it to keep the content relevant and current, updated. Keep copies of important messages and consider archiving messages that you may need later. With this, I hope you have learned certain possibilities which will help you become a better manager of your email in times to come. Let's wait for the next series to give you some more important guidelines to help you look good online. Thank you.